General Bartlett, General Hickerson, Sergeant Major Turner, and Sergeant Tran, fellow non-commissioned officers. I know there's a few more behind me out there, officers, ladies and gentlemen, but mostly cadets. And I understand that all of our Marine and Navy and Air Force comrades have departed the scene. But that's okay. If you run into them, I hope you'll pass on some of the things that I want to talk to you about today. I thought long and hard about what I was going to talk to you about today, and then it really occurred to me that this is going to be pretty easy, because it's what I've been doing for the last 37 years now, and I know that scares some of you, but I have been a non-commissioned officer for 35 of those 37 years. I've been a sergeant major for over 17 of that. So I really love what I do. And part of what I do is train, teach, coach, and mentor soldiers. And so I would hope that through my ramblings this morning, something I say to you sticks and resonates and comes back to you at some point, because everything I'm going to say to you is important to me, and it should be important to you as future leaders in our Army or in the civilian world if you decide that's the course you're going to take. I'm often glad I don't have to follow General Sullivan this morning, because every time he talks, he gets me to the point where I want to reenlist. He almost gets me to tears. That's the kind of soldier he is and has been. Saw last night was General Sullivan. That is who he is, and it's always good. Sir, thanks for the kind words this morning as well. Officer-NCO relationship. I think that you're all going to sort that out in your own right, but I'll tell you, it's a relationship that's built on trust. There is no regulation that prescribes it. There's no magic formula that says add two of those and turn one of these and you're going to get a good one. So it is built on a lot of trust. And when you look at the NCOs that you have at your schools, and I know just about every school out there has got a senior non-commissioned officer working in it, you learn a lot through osmosis, just watching how they act, what they do, what they respond to, what's important to them, what they won't let you get away with, what they cause you to do. And sometimes it's fun, sometimes it's painful, but it's always because they care about you. What's the standard? That's a question you're going to ask yourselves 1,000 times, if not 10,000 times. What's the standard? Because, as a former Sergeant Major of the Army said, this is the easiest business in the world. All you have to do is follow the standard. No imagination required. Somebody's already done it before you if you care enough to investigate and find out what the standard is. You don't have to make it up. You just have to do it. But what's the standard becomes very important. And I'm going to talk a little bit more about how standards impact your day-to-day life and the things that happen to you out there on the battlefield, back in garrison, on leave, and so forth. Every time you complete a task, you have set the bar for the standard. So what is the standard you want to set? How high do you want it to be? Because nobody's going to let you set and maintain low standards. It's high standards that we're after. That's the organization we're in. That's why you're sitting here and not sitting somewhere else in civilian clothes and a t-shirt with a hole in it. Some words we live by in the Army. You find them on the values tag and so forth, and I'm only going to talk about a couple of them. Loyalty. Some of you already know what that is because you've had to exercise it or had the opportunity to exercise it. But when you put on that gold bar and step in front of your first element, they're going to give you loyalty because that's what you're wearing on your shoulder. You're going to continue to earn it every day by your actions and the things you do to demonstrate loyalty. just like respect goes both ways. If you demonstrate respect, you demonstrate loyalty, and you guys can be chasing that sun around for a while, because I know which way it's moving, but that's okay. We were watching it up here at the head table last night, and everybody was ducking and trying to get out of the way, so it was chasing them around the room. That loyalty is very important, though, because that's the thing that's going to help bind your teams. A lot of other things go into forming that team, but loyalty is right up at the top of the list. You demonstrate it to your soldiers, they will give it to you to their last dying breath, all things else being equal. Respect is that way as well. You have to earn respect. Nobody gives it to you. You can't demand it. You have to earn it. You do that through your actions. You do that by not negotiating standards. You do that by being right, by being fair, by being honest. Honor is something you can never negotiate away. You've probably seen some examples in the news where soldiers have thrown their honor away. And once it's gone, it's next impossible to get back. It's kind of like cheating. Once you do it, you won't recover from that either, will you? Because people will know you're prone to cheat, you quit when it's hard, and so forth. I challenge each of you to become expert at your craft, whatever it is. If you're going to be an aviator, then be an expert aviator. If you're going to be an artilleryman, you better know everything about that job. If you're going to be in finance, do not mess with my pay. But become an expert at your craft. Quite a few of you have got some pretty interesting school backgrounds. You may not know it, but everything that you've learned, you're going to use at some point in the future. All that math that you resisted when you were in grade school and junior high school, you couldn't get where you are now without it. Those dangling participles and, that was pain, wasn't it? but if you think about those kinds of things, they're going to help you in the future. But continue to be an expert, not just in your craft, but in what it is you do. Don't stop your education. Some of you probably have plans that when you get your degree, that's it. But when your day comes, you stop learning, you stop contributing to that organization. You've got to continue to learn and grow and get better every day. Expand your horizons. Listen to a new kind of music. Read a different kind of book. Learn a new skill. You hear a lot in the news about things that really are indicators of leadership. The indicators of leadership, and we measure these on a continual basis, are morale, proficiency, esprit, and discipline. When you hear that soldiers, a couple of years ago in Iraq, it was very popular for reporters to question soldier morale. It's kind of hard to do that when you got 1,000 soldiers reenlisted in a mass ceremony, not once, not twice, but many times, hundreds reenlisting to stay in the combat zone, not to go home. Morale is easy to measure if you look in eyes. When you have one or two soldiers in an organization who aren't having a good day, that's probably an individual thing. When you got several, you need to start looking inward, because that's an indicator of your presence or absence of leadership. Now, you are the ones that are going to be in a position to decide how that goes in your platoon, your company, your battalion, your brigade, someday, like the chief, your army.